Even,
SDX?
Even Nettle, like Abadongo, really just kind of like Abadongo stopped. Like he's, dropped him, yeah. He stopped playing Mewtwo for the most part. So we're going to be going into game one here on a Smashville. Not too surprised by that, especially with the way that these both play.
Wow.
They definitely take advantage of that platform on the far side. And as you're seeing, SDX already taking pretty much full control of the beginning of this match over Glare.
Yeah, we saw Glare actually try to air dodge through the Nair from SDX, but the Bat Within did not save him. He still got hit with it anyway and got forced to the ledge, which gave SDX enough time to charge a fully charged Shadow Ball. And now look at the lead he's been able to accumulate because of that one scenario.
Mm-hmm. He's been getting most of his damage being on the back pedal. Like, he hasn't really committed to going after Glare at all. And one of the things that SDX does a lot is read air dodges. Like every time.
What did you say?
One of the things that SDX loves to do a lot is
read air dodges. Say it louder for the people in back.
Oh my God, man. It's something that I've seen consistently throughout the whole day. And now hopefully Glare can get something big off of this here. It looks like he's getting a little bit, but unfortunately went to the wrong side and SDX able to get out of there.
And he's going to go ahead, charge that Shadow Ball as much as he can every time he manages to connect one of that purple ball of energy to Glare's face. That's a free 26-25% that he's able to rack up there. Keep playing at bay, force Bandito to come to him with all these unsafe moves, and then finish it off with some sort of Nair conversion, a throw, or just another Shadow Ball.
Yeah, and as we're seeing right here, Glare finally getting himself in. Hopefully this back air could take it, and it is. And that's going to be a relatively convincing way to stop the momentum that SDX had before. Now, he is at 44%. And we've seen most of this damage accumulated has been while he's going on reverse. Let's see if SDX actually decides to go a little bit more aggressive now and mess with Glare's head.
Yeah, gets a Nair into dash attack, some good percentage on that. Managed to hit another Shadow Ball, it's another 20-some-odd percent added to Glare's life, and now he's getting to a point where he will have to fear the up throw fairly soon. One or two more hits, and it'll be a lot easier for SDX to get that kill. Also, of course, has that Shadow Claw, but the up smash, just as good.
I was just about to say, Glare's been jumping around a whole lot. We're going to see an anti-air option come in pretty soon. And SDX was just all over it. He knew. He was like, all right, cool. I missed the first one. You're still going to be jumping. And one of the things I noticed from Glare from that game one that I'm not used to seeing is that Glare was landing on top of Mewtwo a lot. Like, I'm not used to seeing him. Usually he'll, like, go on the back pedal and kind of just, like, run away and be safe. But instead, he's landing directly on top of him, and that's a recipe for a disaster.
Game two, going to town and city. Hopefully, Glare's going to be able to get a little bit more of an edge around. He realizes now, hopefully, from that statement of Smash, that he needs to kind of chill with the way he's jumping around, mix up the timing a little bit. And this is a very strong way to start. Not able to get the ABK, though, because it's a little too high. Mm-hmm. Good DI coming out from SDX to keep him out of that scenario.
Yeah, as we're seeing, Glare throwing out a lot more hitbox options here just his approach to keep himself a little bit safer. But SDX, I think he wanted to go for a drop down dare there to get a strong extended combo, but waiting for the spot dodge, and SDX just playing very, very well in regards to how to approach an aggressive Bayonetta.
Yeah, and one of the things I saw there from Glare in that last conversion, that he's trying to go for that single hit witch twist, kind of bring him up to that certain amount where it's a lot easier to catch the combos. Not quite enough, but I always do love seeing that extra step taken in a Bayonetta's punish game to really try and convert, and that's one way. What the heck?
He actually, even with the backdrift of the neutral beat, he managed to make some get back. He never blew his his jump. But what a great answer to that attempted disable. Get out of my face, and Glare able to take the first stock.
All right, well, there you go. Already starting off looking pretty good. 104, going for too many heel slides, man. Come on now. This is the first thing that anyone talks about Bayonetta's. They don't want to play neutral. They just want to throw out a heel slide and get maximum conversions. You cannot do that when you're in losers top eight. Like, people are...
If there's one place where you don't want to autopilot heel slides, this is definitely one of them. And Glare actually was smiling it off when he did it because he knew. He was like, all right, I done messed up. Now he's opting. Oh, my God. No air dodge reads attempts there. Just goes 1, 2, and 3. And Glare couldn't do anything about it. SDX taking a very convincing game two again. And Glare on the back pedal down 2-0. I don't know.
I mean, the ending of that game, like, they both couldn't even believe it. SDX looked at Glare, they looked at SDX, and they both just, like, shook their heads and were like, that worked? Like, I don't know, man.
I don't know.
Like, is that true? I don't know. I just did it.
I'm not going to lie. For, like, a second there, I thought we might see the return of the Glare Donkey Kong just because this hasn't been working. And maybe he just picks the Donkey Kong for the sake of trying to get something different on the board, but opting to stay with the Bayonetta, it is what has been working for him and giving him a lot of success recently. And hopefully he could find some kind of answer to SDX. But here's the thing, though. SDX being up two games, he can play as, I don't mean to say it this way, but he can play as lame and patient as he wants.
Right.
Because there's nothing he needs to really do in terms of commitment. He's already up two games.
Yeah, the way I always look to say it, if you want to say someone's, like, playing lame, just say efficient. You know what I mean? He's playing efficient. You know, definitely don't need to push your lead.
It's the optimal play style at that time. Why approach when you already have such a large lead? That's what I'm getting at. And as we saw, SDX pretty much only go for aggro options like when he has offstage situations. And now that he sees Glare offstage, actually get a back off a little bit, couldn't get over to him before the ABK.
Wow, was able to tech on that platform just before the Witch Twist came out. And wow, that balloon might have actually stopped Glare's conversion there as well. But he is still managing to keep it relatively close. But you've seen it already. That's just one quick conversion or one small mistake from Glare can lead to his stock. Mewtwo has so much kill potential.
He actually opted not to go for the up air there. I don't know where Glare is going.
Yeah, he's out of there. Deuce, this is what I was talking about. And watch your landing.
And that's what I meant before as well. He keeps landing directly on top of SDX.
Infinity Gauntlet.
Oh, my God. All right, so who needs neutral when you can just drop down an up smash, man? And that worked out well for Glare and actually going to keep himself in this game.
Yeah, looking just like Jin from Marvel's Capcom 2 with the Flatia!
Ooh, great reference, great reference. Where my boy Captain Commando
I'm
at?
I'm saying.
All right, so we're going getting back into this genre of fighter, though. Currently, DestinyX just continuing to harass Glare, but Glare finally getting in with the single hit fair.
Oh,
can he take
no.
this? No, he can't. And
wait a second, he doesn't have another Witch Twist. He already used them both, yeah!
He was too far off the side of the stage, and Glare's going to free fall to death. You hate to see that kind of thing happen. And
that would be a quick 3-0 for SDX, though, right?
Yeah, it's Glare throwing something down on the floor. Not sure. I think it was his phone. But, yeah, you know, that's just – it's unfortunate, but we take those.
It'd be like that sometimes,
yeah,
man.
Like, hey, sometimes your road to victory to get that money to go to Bobby Flay's instead of McDonald's equals somebody killing themselves. So,
yeah.
hey, so we're going to go in – continue.